Hello again and welcome back for another update on the Walmart dog. First, let me say that the outpouring of genuine sympathy and concern for this young dog continues. It's going to be really cold over the next few days. I'm happy to see so many of you care. In fact, you care so much, you've fed the dog over the fence. Toys have also been thrown over for the lonely puppy to play with. And today, someone has even thrown over a couple of blankets to help keep him warm. We appreciate what you're trying to do, but I'm afraid all the well-meaning good intentions are only causing problems. Listen carefully. Throwing items over the fence is not allowed by Walmart or the city of Monroeville. It's considered littering. I did an interview with Walmart's top man in charge. Here's a snippet of our conversation.
This way, and he could run through our whole system that goes to the other end and stuff.
Yeah, well, I'll be sure to explain to people in this video that you do not want
if they would
anything thrown over the fence.
Right, if they'd stop feeding the dog, because I mean,
we would have a better chance of catching the dog.
Okay, there you heard it straight from the top. As most of you know, attempts to trap the dog, even by the city, have failed. Also, an attempt to tranquilize the dog has also failed. The reason is, he's not trapped in here. He can move freely throughout the culvert system. Since he can't be contained, tranquilizing him is no longer an option. So listen up. Please stop feeding him. Trust me, he will not starve. If we can get him hungry enough, he might let someone approach him. Also, please let those of us who are trying to catch him handle the situation. Unless you are a trained professional operating under the city or Walmart's permission, leave the dog alone. We know you're only trying to help, but if you're not careful, you'll be violating the law. And you may end up inside another kind of fence. Jail. Thanks for watching.